Hi everyone, my name is Heather Coulter and I'm the Teacher Academy Director for OneSchool Global North America. OneSchool Global is the world's largest and most comprehensive school that has 9,500 students in a K-12 program. We have campuses located in 20 countries across the globe, and so there are 120 of them in total, and we really are trying to challenge teaching norms. So we've been on a digital and online teaching journey for about 10 years now, and most of our lessons are conducted over digital platforms where students and teachers are coming together each day. So what you're about to see are samples from some of our online lessons. In this particular example, we have Michelle Weiss, who is our campus principal out of our Detroit campus in the United States of America, and she's demonstrating how it's possible to conduct practical activities like lab experiments when teachers and students may not have access to the typical resources that they would have when the schools are open and functioning in a business as usual kind of model. So I think she's going to do a great job for you and give you some inspiration and some ideas about how you could prepare a flipped learning video or could connect with your students when they don't have the tools that they need to conduct experiments in a typical fashion.
To start this off, we have a mystery demo. And I need you to try to predict and think through, hypothesize, what do you think's happening during the demonstration I'm about to do for you? Now, I'm not going to give you any verbal clues. You have to use your observation skills and just watch right now what's happening. And then you have to think, scientifically, what's actually happening on a very small level in these containers. Are you ready? Here we go. Okay, so I have two containers in front of me, as you can see. And I'm going to add some ingredients to these containers. And you're going to watch what happens. Watching what happens. Not touching them, I'm not moving anything, okay? But keep watching what happens here. Start thinking about, what are you seeing? What are you noticing? What's the same? What's different? This has to do with what we're studying next. I'm gonna let them sit there for just another minute. So, I could sit here all day and let this continue to happen, but I think you get the idea, right? Two containers, something's going on. Use your observation skills. Tell me, why is it that after I added the food coloring to this container, this is what you're seeing, but yet when I added food coloring to this container, this is what you're seeing? What is happening on a molecular level? I did not stir it. I did not touch it. Think about it. Talk to your peers and your friends. I'm going to ask you in 2 minutes to see if you can actually explain this. Do pictures, draw things. I would love to see it. Thanks, guys.
In that short sample, Michelle did an excellent job of showcasing what a virtual lab experiment could look like. And off of that, we have four takeaways for you to consider. The first one is that we can engage students in learning without access to all of the resources that we would typically have. And that links directly to our second key takeaway, which is you will, as a teacher, need to think outside the box, and it's okay to try something different. Sometimes our students get stuck in a little bit of a rut, and so it's great to challenge them with new things and new ideas and approaches to learning content. The third key takeaway is that critical thinking does not have to happen in real time in the classroom. We want to encourage students to develop their critical thinking skills and to work through problems and observe and reflect at any time. So it's okay that it doesn't happen in a face-to-face context. The last key takeaway is really to try and push metacognitive skills. And by that, we mean the ability to observe, to plan, to reflect. Any of those things that would allow students to develop skills that they'll use in the workplace is something great that you can focus on at the moment. We hope that you found this video useful as you consider developing your online teaching and learning programming. You are welcome to subscribe to OneSchool Global's YouTube channel and also follow us on social media. We're pretty active there and you'll be sure to find more videos and helpful hints moving forward. We hope that everyone has a great day and that you're staying well.